हेलो हेलो बोलो।
यस
हेलो आई प्रणव भट्टाचार्य जी ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ विश्व भारती लाइब्रेरी नेटवर्क वेलकम टू ऑल ऑफ यू एंड वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग। नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट proposed second national webinar organized by Vishwa Bharati Library Network. You know, today's speaker is Dr. Kaushik Ghosh, Assistant Librarian, Vishwa Bharati University, Shantiniketan. Already, Dr. Ghosh joined this program. So, good morning, Kaushik.
Thank you, Samantha.
May I request you, please introduce and start your speech.
Okay, thank you once again for that. So before going to my daily business, I am furnishing few information. So first of all, good morning to all the participants, and you are all welcome on behalf of Vishwa Bharati as well as the Vishwa Bharati Library Network. So before going to my question, I congratulate the Vishwa Bharati Vice Chancellor, respected Professor our university library and all the members of the library network. And last but not least, I congratulate and heartfully thank you to the host of the second round of webinar, Dr. Tapas Kumar and Dr. Pranav Bhattacharya. So I am happy for this session. Why we are here? As you know, we are in a pandemic situation of COVID-19 and lockdown situation. We have taken so many initiatives during this situation. And this is the second round of webinar. We have
excuse me, sir. Sound is cool.
Before successfully.
Sound is echoing.
And we are fortunate and glad. Everything is okay. We are glad enough that the second round of introductory lecture and the first lecture delivered by our respected Vice Chancellor sir. And during this period, we have taken a few initiatives like the e-resources, distribution of the e-resources to our client of the user ID and password. And along with, as you know, that the remote access is a very popular service today. And there are different categories of the remote access service like Open Athens by the EBSCO, EasyVoxy from the informatics. And as you know, the InfliNet already introduced the InFET facilities to the Shibboleth technology, but we are using these remote access facilities through the Open Athens software by EBSCO. And we are distributing the user ID and password to our VP fraternity, basically the faculty members and the research scholar. And we are taking so many new initiatives, like we are distributing the few e-resources with user ID and password and a few open access link to our client. And this is the second round of webinar also. So my today's topic is InfliNet in accelerating research activities. And we are all familiar with the terminology InfliNet, the Information Library Network. And this is the system concern of the UGC. And there are lots of digital initiatives and major projects and consortia controlled by the MHRD, controlled by the UGC, and maintained and controlled by the InfliNet also. So it is not possible to explore everything within this stipulated time in one single session. So you need each of the session for the each of the item. So I am trying to furnishing in brief major popular services and facilities and in a brief in manner, because due to shortage of time. And if time permit, I will show you at the last few online demo, if time permit. And if any question, please submit your question to the question box. I will try to answer to you at the end of the session. Otherwise, all the questions you may send to our email address. So let's start. Both. Okay, this is the Infinet Center. As you know, I have already mentioned before, the Information Library Network Center is an autonomous center university center of the University Grant Commission of India, and it is a major national program initiated by the UGC in March 1991. It became an independent inter-university center. I have told you that a sister concern of the UGC. Infinet is involved in modernizing university libraries in India using the set of technologies for the optimal utilization of the information. And Infinet is set out to be a major player in the promoting scholarly communication among the academicians and researchers in India. Okay, what is the objectives and the function? To promote and implement computerization of the operation and services in the libraries and information center of the country following a uniform standard. So among the all universities, so that we can maintain the all uniformity among the all central universities and other institutions. To evolve the standard uniform guideline to techniques, methods, procedure, computer hardware and software, services and promote their adoption in actual practice by the libraries in order to facilitate pooling, sharing and exchange of information towards the optimal use of resources and facilities. To evolve a national network interconnecting various libraries and information centers in the country and to improve capability in information handling and services. And objectives and function: to develop new methods and techniques for archival of the valuable information available as manuscript and information documents in different Indian languages. To encourage cooperation among the libraries, documentation center and information center in the country so that the resources can be pooled for the benefit of the helping and weaker resource center by stronger ones. And to train and develop human resources in the field of the computerized library operations and networking to establish, manage and sustain the internet. To have access the information regarding the serial, thesis, dissertation, books, monographs, and non-book materials by locating the sources where from available and event catalog of the document. And this is the mission and vision of the Infinet Center. So build and strengthening the ICT information communication technology infrastructure in educational institutions with value-added services, develop resource selection guides and online tutorial for effective the delivery and usage of the e-resources and facilitate creation of open access digital repositories in every educational institution for hosting educational research content and created by this institution. And I have already mentioned before, there are so many major activities and it is not possible to explore everything within this stipulated time. And I am categorized a few main segments of major activities like e-consortia, open access initiatives, project and consultancy. Under the consortia, two major activities like Ishod Sindhu and Shod Shubhi, open access initiative like InfoPort, institutional repository of the Infinet, Shod Ganga, Shod Gangotri, project and consultancy like NIRF, EPT Parthala, Vidyan Database, IRINS and Vidya Mitra. These are the very popular and important major activities. Apart from these, there are so many other activities also. So I am now furnishing and highlight in brief, one by one, according to this particular major popular activities. First, Ishod Sindhu. Hope you are all familiar with the ESS. The MHRD has formed the Ishod Sindhu before three consortia, merging three consortia. As you know, there are before three consortia, name UGC Infinet Digital Library Consortia, NLIST and INDES ICTE Consortia. Now these three consortia is merged for us and renamed as Ishod Sindhu. The Ishod Sindhu will continue to provide the current as well as the archival access to more than 15,000 core and peer reviewed journals and few bibliographic databases also. What is the aims and objectives of the ESS, that is the Ishod Sindhu? Bridge the digital divide and the move towards the information rich society, monitor and promote usage of the e-resources in the member institutions in India through awareness and training program, provide access to subscription-based scholarly information, and developed a formidable collection of e-journals, e-journal archives, and e-books on the perpetual access mode, and moving towards the developing a national electronic library with electronic journals and electronic books as its major building and block. This is the homepage of the ESS. As you know, that all the government institution are tied up with this ESS platform, and in this COVID-19 situation, they are providing more than free resources from the different publisher, and it is also available and linked with this website also. And in the bottom link, there are more than, this is the institution, 217 universities along with the central universities, the state universities, and total college. And this is the total more than 10,000 e-journals, and this is the e-books, and this is the different publisher and aggregator, 22 resources and 4 databases. And this is very familiar homepage of the eSoch Sindhu. And as you saw, this is the member category. As you know, in case of Vishwa Bharati, we are belong from the central university. And there are different categories of the institution, like the state universities, central universities, BB universities, national law and school universities. And we are, as in case of Vishwa Bharati, we are belong from the central university, as present 40 central universities under this consortia. So if we go directly from the ESS, we are directly go to the member category, then the select the your institution, like in VV, we select the central university, and there are more than central universities, and all the central universities are arranged alphabetically. Like Aligarh Muslim University stand first due to the alphabetically A, then Assam University, then BHU, and Vishwa Bharati stand last due to the alphabetically V. So you can go directly according to alphabetically the Vishwa Bharati. I am showing the resources subscribed by the Vishwa Bharati from the ESS platform. And this is the screenshot of the ESS in case of Vishwa Bharati. As you shown, show here, this is the e-resources, this is the subscription period, this is the subscription type, and this is the journal. You can click according to your need, and this is the downloadable option, and this is the more option. This is the more related to the American Chemical Society. This is the more information related to American Institute of Physics. And these are the e-resources along in the few online databases. And apart from this, Shodshuddhi access, like the Urkun plagiarism detecting software, also providing from the ESS platform. And apart from this, there are two another NDL e-resources, that is World eBook Library and South Asia Archives. So I am furnishing in such a way the information relating to the major activities on the internet. So this is the e-resources accessible from the Vishwa Bharati Library Network, from the ESS platform. More than 7,000 e-resources are accessible from this platform. Like American Chemical Society, there are 49 journals. American Institute of Physics, 19 journals. American Physical Society, 15 journals. This is the subject related. And this is the annual reviews, 43 journals, Economic and Political Weekly, very important for those who are belong to the social science and humanities and economics and education. And yesterday, I am furnishing one information. One research scholar told me yesterday and sent the mail. So I need a article from Nanaji Deshmukh. So yesterday, I collect this particular Nanaji Deshmukh article related to this from the EPWD. And this is another information for the Vishwa Bharati fraternity community. This year we have purchased another database, such kind of EPWD, that is the EPWDRF Research Foundation. And this is also very applicable those who are belong from the economics, education, agriculture. And now the gesture, very familiar and popular. There are more than 3,165 journals, Oxford University Press, 262 journals, Project Muse, 676 journals, Springer Link, 1,724 journals, Taylor and Francis, 1,078 journals. This is the journals, and apart from these, Institute for Studies in Industrial Development, we can say IS ID, JGET Plus, MathScienceAid, Web of Science. This is the four online databases. Apart from this, for the Vishwabharati, we are purchased several few another databases like IndiaStat, few another journals from the IOP, those who are belong from the physics, and few journals from the Bentham Science, those who are belongs from the chemistry, and all the purchases apart from the ESS product, and we purchase from the negotiation rate of the ESS. So at a glance, more than 7,000 e-resources, it is accessible for the Vishwabharati Library Network. Next, my point is Shodshuddhi. The terminology reveal the what kind of services the Shodshuddhi provided. Based on the recommendation of the subcommittee, National Screening Committee of the Ishod Sindhu, the MHRD Government of India has initiated a program, Shodshuddhi, which provides access to plagiarism detection, that is the PDS, to all universities, institutions from 2019. The institution covered from the central universities, state universities, deemed to be universities, private universities, central funded universities. And under this initiative, Urkund, a web-based plagiarism detective software system is being provided to all universities and institutions in the country. So why Urkund? Urkund is a fully automatic machine learning test recognition system made for detecting, preventing, and handling plagiarism, no matter which language you are writing in. So I am furnishing another information regarding the language. So in case of regional language, basically the Bengali, Urdu, Hindi, Odia. So you should maintain the Unicode support language. Otherwise, result it is not possible to explore through the Urkund. Otherwise, the result will be show zero. So my humble request to the faculty member along with the scholar, please, those who are belong from the research going related to the those who are belong from the regional languages in mention, I have already mentioned before, please try to work the software with the Unicode support. So at present, 17 countries already using the Urkund, and is the Swedish software and very easy to use, efficient and reliable. So this is the homepage of the Shodshuddhi. So it was launched by our Honorable HRD Minister, Government of India, Sri Ramesh Pokhriyal Nishank. And at present, more than 1,032 institutes already member, and total user, basically those who are belong from the account of the analysis account, more than 81,643 total user, and these are the document already submitted, and I have prepared this PPT yesterday, day before yesterday. So this is the latest updated result. So this is the homepage of the Shodshuddhi, and this is the homepage of the Urkund software. So this is the logging facilities here, and this is the remote request for the demo action. I have a furnishing another information that the Urkund already introduced the new version. So this is the new version of the homepage of the plagiarism prevention that simply works. This is the homepage, and so it is the logging page. So there are two kinds of user ID and password. First, you have to enter through the user ID password. Basically, the email ID is your user ID and password. And but our university librarian, Dr. Nimaichal Saha, is the nodal officer. So for the Vishwabharati community, basically the faculty member, those who are not yet having their user ID password, already given the link to their email ID. Otherwise, those who are having no user ID and password, please send us the request for giving the user ID and password. So I am showing, this is my email ID, kausik.ghosh@vishwabharati.ac.in. Please use your email ID under the Vishwabharati domain, and this is the password. Then you have entered the system, and this is the uploading page. After uploading page, I am showing in brief. It is not possible to, it is not the hands-on training, it is not the online demo. So I am just showing the screenshot. So before enters, you have to submit the analysis account. So apart from the user ID and password, there is a separate analysis account. This is my analysis account, kausik.ghosh. at the rate of .vbuni at the rate of analysis.utkun.com. So after setting the analysis account, this is not the mandatory field for subject and message. So this is the Dropbox. You have to upload your article or the thesis. So I am furnishing another information regarding the article or thesis. So during uploading the thesis, so create a master file, one master file, whether it is a Word file or the PDF file, from introduction to conclusion, excluding the preliminary pages, excluding the bibliography and reference, only in-text citation within the text, and then upload, and result will, it will be show the result within 5 to 10 minutes, depends on the file size. So my next slide show the result part. So I have already is the previous work. So I am showing the particular one MPhil thesis already submitted few days ago. So this is the MPhil, and the result show the 2%. So after showing the result, so this is the analysis part, and in new Urkund format, all details, it will showing everything regarding the your how many percentage copying from different sources, etc., etc. And next, there is a facility to export your result by clicking this button, and the total analysis report converted into a PDF format like a export. And I am showing you the, this is the export result in, this is the export result of the analysis part. So this is the title of the MPhil thesis by the contributor, and this is the date of submission, and this is the analysis account, and this is the significance, this is the 1%. Then you have to incorporate the first page of the report into your physical part of your thesis, as well as the soft copy of the thesis. And without having this report, it is not possible to submit the thesis, because the academic research of the Visvabharati University already check whether it is Urkund, the report is available or not. So I am showing such a screenshot of Urkund. And as you know, that Visvabharati Library Network used to organize throughout the year, every month, twice, in such kind of special session. Maybe Urkund, maybe remote access, maybe discovery service, apart from this pandemic situation. So this is for your information also. And next, another project, InfoPort. This is the subject gateway for Indian electronic research. Basically, this is all the resources are available from the Indian resources and open source software, all the resources. The InfoPort Center promotes open access to Indian scholarly content through the InfoPort, a subject gateway for Indian electronic resources. The InfoPort is designed and developed to serve as the comprehensive gateway to all the Indian scholarly content. The InfoPort selectively catalogs online resources of Indian origin on diversified subjects available in open access through an elaborate process of testing and evaluation. At present, those who are belong from the library science professional, these open Indian sources are alphabetically arranged according to the DDC DUI decimal manner from the 000 to 999 concept. And these are the InfoPort content internet resources of the Indian origin in the following categories. There are large coverages of the Indian origin, like electronic books, electronic journals and reference sources, institutional repository, resource gateway, wiki, blogs, and many more. So Kyle, my humble request to you, please use this InfoPort project for Indian origin and open sources. So this is the homepage of the InfoPort. And as you show, this is the browse subject-wise alphabetically and arranged according to the DDC from Generalia class to 999. So, and it is, you may extract your requisite data. Now this is the alphabetically arranged and total resources 1,742. And these are the total unique resources. So I am skipping this slide. So institutional repository. It is very important for the library professional among with the scholar and faculty member. Institutional repository is very important and applicable in any institute. In case of Vishwa Bharati, we have a very enriched institutional repository which is available in our library website. So institutional repository in case of InfliptNet, so where you can find article published in the all the conventional societies of InfliptNet Center. And as you know that each year InfliptNet organize one convention at Calibre and another such kind of planner basically for the Northeast region. All the proceedings of the Calibre and all the proceedings of the planner is available in this institutional diversity. Apart from this, InfliptNet in press and media, InfliptNet convention proceeding, InfliptNet publication, all is available in the InfliptNet institutional repository. This is the homepage of the institutional repository, and this is the author index, this is the subject index, and this is the date wise. You may extract according to your choice. This is the, I am showing you the author wise. This is the Jagdish Arora sir. There are 18 article from Jagdish Arora sir, and he was the then director of the InfliptNet. So you can extract according to your choice, and this is the subject categories: academic libraries, consortia, digital library, and how many within the bracket. This is the number of the articles. So Shodh Gangotri, very important for the in research and research scholar, the repository of Indian research in progress. The word Shodh originates from the Sanskrit and stands for research and discovery. Gangotri is one of the largest glacier in the Himalayas. And source of originating of Ganges, the holiest, longest, largest river in India. The Ganges is the symbol of age-long culture, civilization, ever-aging, ever-flowing, ever-loving, loved by its people. Under the initiative called Shodh Gangotri, research scholar and research supervisor is in universities as requested to deposit electronic version of approved research proposal submitted by the research scholar to the universities for registering themselves for the PhD program. The repository, one hand, would reveal the trends and direction of the research being conducted by in Indian universities. On the other hand, it would avoid the duplication of the research. Research proposal in Shodh Gangotri would later be mapped in full text. This is Shodh Ganga. As Ganga, Shodh Gangotri is the origin of the Ganga. So Shodh Gangotri. Shodh Ganga comes from the Shodh Gangotri. So research proposal first, then the research. So this is the homepage of the Shodh Gangotri, that is research proposal part. So it is not familiar as like with the Shodh Ganga. So total number of proposal uploaded from yesterday, 7,645. At present, in case of Vishwa Bharati, we have uploaded 290 research proposal, and at present we are stand rank fifth. The first, this is the first university maximum uploaded. This is the second university. This is the second university. This is the third university, and this is the fourth university. And university Vishwa Bharati already stand rank in case of research proposal. My humble request to the research scholar, those who are belong from the different universities, after registration, after BOS, after approval of your research proposal, kindly arrange to upload your research proposal by own. There is a user-friendly guideline how to upload your research proposal. And in case of Vishwa Bharati, those who are not possible to upload, please come with us. We will arrange to upload. And there is a very user-friendly guide to how to upload your research proposal. So I am showing the Vishwa Bharati page in case of research proposal, that is Shodh Gangotri. There are 290 research proposal already uploaded from the recently. And in case of agriculture, 20, this is the ancient history, 13, biotechnology, 6, and many more. So hopefully in near future, we'll uploading many more research proposal to know the trend of the research and to avoid the duplication of the research. And this is the next Shodh Ganga. So I have already mentioned before, the origin of the Shodh Ganga is the Shodh Gangotri. As origin of the Ganga is Gangotri. So Shodh Ganga is the name coined to denote digital repository of Indian electronic thesis and dissertation. I am add another point. As 2009 regulation, you have to submit both your hard copy and soft copy. And before 2009 regulation, there is no soft copy system. So it is now mandatory to submit your thesis both hard copy and soft copy. The word Shodh originates from the Sanskrit and stand for research and discovery. The Ganga is the holiest, largest, and longest of all rivers in Indian subcontinent. The Ganga is the symbol of the India's age-long culture, civilization, ever-changing, ever-flowing, ever-loved and revered by the its people, and has held India's heart captive and drawn uncounted millions to her banks since the dawn of history. Shodh Ganga stands for the reservoir of Indian intellectual output stored in the repository hosted and maintained by the Internet Center. So objectives of the Shodh Ganga: providing access to Indian thesis in open access to worldwide academic community, setting up of ETD, that is electronic thesis and dissertation laboratory in eligible universities, and extending access to anti-plagiarism software package in member universities, and fund for digitization of backlist of the thesis available in universities. I have already mentioned before that a backlog of the hard copy of the thesis before 2019 regulation. In case of Vishwa Bharati, we have uploaded the thesis after the regulation of the 2019. But the back volume of the hard copy of the thesis, we are not yet uploaded, because we have at present not yet the ETD laboratory and the same system. But in near future, we have already applied for the same to the Infinet authority. And in near future, if we arrange the ETD laboratory, the back volume of the hard copy of the thesis of the Vishwa Bharati will upload soon. So this is the homepage of the Shodh Ganga project. And these are the top 20 subjects in 1,000 thesis updated in last 2020 in January, February, last 2 months. And but after COVID-19, the result is remain same. So total number of thesis uploaded in 2019, everything is available in graphically. So this is the search option. You may search your thesis according to your title of the thesis, according to the department, according to the university, according to the keyword, according to the contributor, according to the supervisor. So there are user-friendly Shodh Ganga site. So these are the guide and tutorial also. And this is the Shodh Ganga next page, and top 10 university. I am showing the top 10 universities as present. And at present, University of Calcutta is the stand first, because they have already digitized all the back volume of the thesis of 2009 regulation. At present, 11,908 thesis uploaded in Shodh Ganga reservoir. And at present, University of Madras stand second. And these are the third university, and this is the fourth university. Anna University is the fifth, and so on. This is the top 10 universities. At present, there are this number is the full text thesis, and this is the universities. And in this category, 514 universities have already moved with the Infinet Center. And among the 514 universities, 428 university already started working in this category. So in case of Vishwa Bharati, I am showing at present 767 thesis already uploaded, because I have already mentioned before the only soft copy is available under 2009 regulation. So this is the scenario in case of Vishwa Bharati, and this is the subject wise, and this is the language wise uploaded. And in case of Vishwa Bharati, as soon as the thesis awarded from the university, an examination section send us the both hard copy and the soft copy of the thesis to the central library. And hard copy of the thesis is available in our journal section within the compactor. And the soft copy of the thesis is available in Shodh Ganga as well as in our server. You can search the awarded thesis from our system by selecting the parameter in OPAC by thesis, And otherwise, you may collect your thesis from the Shodh Ganga from your drawing room also. And it is downloadable. So chapter wise, it is downloadable. So this is the contribution of the Vishwabharati in Shodh Ganga. So this is the very important another. So may I request to host Akulta and Sanoda due to the time killing from the beginning time. So I need another 30 minutes. Otherwise, it is not possible to.
Yeah, you can carry on.
Okay. So this is the very important national institutional ranking framework. So few days before, already already the list is published, and the national institutional ranking framework was approved by the MHRD and launched by Honorable Minister of the Human Resource Development on September 2015, and it was introduced in 2015. This framework outlines a methodology to rank institutes across the country. There are a few parameters like teaching learning resources and research and professional practices, graduation outcomes, outreach and inclusivity, and perception. These are the few parameters, and based on these parameters, the Implement Center under the control of the MHRD will publish every year from 2019-15 the rank. And these are the parameters of NIRF. I have already mentioned the five segments, that is teaching, learning, and resources, which is called TLR. Under the TLR, students, then including the doctoral student, faculty student ratio with emphasis on the permanent faculty, combined metric for faculty with the PhD and experience, and financial resources and their utilization, very important in case of any institution. And RP, that is the research and professional practice. Combined metric for publication, very important. Combined metric for quality publication, IPR and patent, published and granted, and footprint projects and the professional practices. And next point, GO, graduation outcomes. Metric for university examination, metric for number of PhD students graduated, very, very important in any institution for rank up. And outreach and exclusively, that is called OI. Percentage of students from other state, it is very important for any institute, other state and country. Percentage of women, very important, economically and socially challenged student, and facilities for physically challenged student, and perception is very important. So last point, peer perception, academic peers and perception. I am not going details because we have a separate session on this NIRF ranking in next webinar. So this is the few important parameter. So this is the home page of the NIRF pages. And last 11th June, it was published by our Honorable HRD Minister Ramesh Pokhriyal Nishang. And all are familiar with their existing list, their rank. And this is showing the parameter from this home page. So very important another part, EPG Patsala. So this is the gateway called PG courses. So EPG Patsala is an initiative of the MHRD under its national mission, that is the NMEICT. And more than 70 subjects are available across all disciplines of social science, arts, fine arts, and humanities, natural and mathematical sciences. And as you know, there are three another important platform of eodhayan, UGC MOOCs and ePathyo. eOdhyayan basically dealings with the ebooks available. I am showing later. eOdhyayan, that is basically the ebooks, UGC MOOCs, all are familiar with these online courses, and ePathyo is the offline access. Recently, MHRD already tie up in three eOdhyayan, UGC MOOCs, and ePathyo under the umbrella of EPG Patsala. Recently, it was introduced, and this is the homepage of the EPG Patsala. I have already mentioned before, the three UGC books and the ePathyo and the eOdhyayan is under tie-up with the umbrella of the EPG Patsala. So my humble request, there are lots of resources and facilities and services provided by the government of India, and all are accessible and maintained by the internet. So please use and familiar with each of the particular objects. So these are the lists of the subject category. I have already mentioned that there are 70 subjects in different categories, and these are the subject under bracket, the total number of subjects, the adult education, architecture, biophysics, all the subjects is arranged according to alphabetically, and this is the e-test, this is the e-video, this is the expert, this is the quiz, and this is the 70 subject. So all are very present here, very user-friendly manner and very easy to access. So Vidyan, so this is the next very important project. Sorry. In case of Vishwa Bharati University, so I have circular few days before, one circular regarding the Vidyan expert databases, and one submitted one Excel sheet for the urine. So these Vidyan expert databases, very unique databases, and in near future, the NIR5 ranking in case of NAC, and as you know that all few of the publisher already arranged the university's ranking, like few days ago, the Nature already, Nature publisher. So as you know that the Nature is now tied up with the Springer Nature. So Nature already published one institutional ranking, and they are providing the data from Vidyan along with the urines. So to popular and familiarize and increase the usage, we are already submitted one circular to our faculty member. Please logging and increase your Vidyan expert database. What is the Vidyan database? Vidyan is the premier database of the profile of scientists and researchers and other faculty members working at the leading academic institution and other research and development organization involved in teaching and research in India. It provides important information about the expert background, contact, address, experience, scholarly publication, skill, and accomplishment, researcher identity, etc. And all the your information is under in a single umbrella. The database developed and maintained by the InfibNet. The database would be instrumental in selecting the panels of experts for various committees, task force established by the ministries, government or establishment for monitoring and evaluation of the purpose. So we are already creating from last notification and increasing our database and objectives of the Vidyan. Quickly and conveniently provide information about the expert to peers, prospective collaborators, funding agencies, policymakers, and research scholar in the country. Identify peer reviews for articles and research proposals, and discover prospective collaborators for ongoing research project. Establish communication directly with the expert who possesses the expertise needed by the user to create information exchange and networking opportunities among the scientists. And this is the homepage of the Vidyan, very user-friendly homepage. And this is the logging page. This is the registration part. Hope those who are having with their email ID with Google, Gmail, you need not use the separate user ID password. You may use your existing Google account to enter this databases. And then one by one, you have to incorporate your data, your credential, your publication. And in case, it is very unique that if you having your account with a Google Scholar or Copas or any other ORCID, you need not separately input your data by manually. In case of Google Scholar, hope you are all having their Google Scholar account. So in there is a provision of in Google Scholar that there is export facilities. Your publication is having with the Google Scholar, and there is export facilities. You export your all bibliographic details basically in publication and save your extract file in your external device or the your desktop. And in case of Vidyan, there is a facilities to fetch your publication details in Vidyan. No need to separately data entry in case of publication one by one. This is the unique feature. So this is the Vidyan homepage. So why Vidyan? Discover potential collaborator for research proposal, review interdisciplinary research project, showcase credential, expertise, skill, and professional achievements of faculty, scientists, and organization to the peer group, connect with focus areas and geographic expertise. So all our expertise in a single umbrella within the Vidyan, integrate with the external academic identity and other sources. So this is why Vidyan, and this is the another page of the Vidyan. Who can join? All the faculty member from assistant professor, associate professor and professor, library professional, assistant librarian onward, and director physical education, those who are, and the officers also. And these are the parameters who can join in the Vidyan. And as for example, I am showing you one Vidyan databases. This is my Vidyan pages, so that you can familiar with your Vidyan databases. And these are the this profile parameters. You have to update your profile parameters every day as you need. And this is the profile progress. This is the personal profile. This is the expertise profile. This is the experience profile. This is the qualification. This is the academic identity. And this is the publication. And this is the very unique. This is the unique ID of Vidyan. And in many cases, we need our CV in our higher education, in our higher appointment. So you need not require any separate CV. And there is a facility to download the CV according to the data input in the Vidyan. And this is my page showing. This is the everything is here. And I am belong from the Vishwabharati University. And at present, this is the same organization from the Vishwabharati University. And this I am prepared this slide day before yesterday. So this is the latest data. At present, this is the 79 already faculty members and a library professional enroll in the Vidyan. And before circulating our notice, it was showing the 42 or 43. Hope within a week or within a month, and it will be increased rapidly, so that in our forthcoming NIRF ranking and any other ranking in NAC, it will need more appropriate. So this is the another view of the Vidyan databases, and it is the publication area. This is the co-author related. Everything is there. They're very user-friendly. And I hope you are all having their ORCID account, the COPAS account, the ResearchGate account, and this is the Google Scholar account. All are fetching automatically by system. So my humble request, those who are belong from the Bishop, not only Vishwabharati, all the faculty members in different institutions, even scholar, please enroll your databases and enrich your university in Vidyan. So next, earrings. It is basically related to the Vidyan and earrings. You need not require any updation in earrings. Automatically, it is related from the Vidyan to earrings, because all the data is fetching from the Vidyan. So that's why during our circular, we have already circulate one Excel data sheet, and all the data sheet under the data sheet, all the modules is mandatory field. So please send the data by fill up your data sheet, so that we can enrich the ERINS. What is ERINS? ERINS is the web-based research information management service developed by the InfliPNet Center in collaboration with the Central University of Punjab. So Punjab University is now doing a very great job in this part. The portal facilities, the academic research and development organization, and faculty members, scientists, to collect, curate, and showcase the scholarly communication activities, and provide an opportunity to create the scholarly network. The ERINS is available as free software as service to the academic research organization in India. The ERINS would support to integrate the existing research management system, such as HR system, course management, grant management system, institutional repository, open and commercial citation databases, scholarly publish, and it has integrated with the academic identity such as ORCID ID, COPAS ID, Research ID, Microsoft Academic ID, Google Scholar, I have mentioned before, for ingesting the scholarly publication from various sources. So I am add another information. In case of ERINS, so hope you have having your Google Scholar ID. you have not yet enrolled as a Microsoft Academic ID or ORCID ID, but in case of ERINS, this is a mandatory field. To create your ORCID account, create your Scopus ID account, or create your Microsoft Academic account with zero credential. But only the ID is necessary in case of ERINS because it is the mandatory field. So within a few months, hope we will enrich our ERINS platform. Why ERINS? Faculty research scholar, faculty member, and research administrator. Research scholar, it provides the immense support to the fine mentors or advisor for their research in the respective domain. It helps the scholar to locate courses in their subject interest and research focus on the department and organization. And it provides scholarly metadata related to the search interest of faculty members and research focus of the departments of the school. In case of faculty, it supports the faculty member to showcase their research contribution to the peer group. It provides more significant exposure for their research contribution to the international community and brings funding opportunities from the national and international agencies and improve the research metadata quality and reduce the repetitive data entry for the various assessment system. And in case of research administrator, it enables the administrator to build research report, performance assessment, research impact analysis, strategically analyze the research progress for better decision making on funding, faculty assessment, and resource allocation, help the internal quality. In case of IQAC, you need not require the separate data sheet. You can fetch your faculty members the data sheet from the ERINS. And the national in NIR ranking. In case of NIR ranking, hopefully in near future, the implement center or the agency or the publisher or the aggregator fetch their data from ERINS databases. And the key feature of the ERINS, this is the discovery, key search area of the research progress of the school, department, faculty members, and faceted search facilities with the number of filters to find expert and their contribution. API ranking, very important. Import publication from the academic identity, such as I have mentioned before, Microsoft Academic Search ID, Google Scholar ID, Researcher ID, COFAS ID, ORCID integration, to engage the profile information with the publication. And visualization, networking of the faculty, through co-author, I have already showing from my databases, the map of science network, graphical representation of the productivity of the department and individual faculty member, and the research impact. Automatic from social media, such as Facebook, Twitter, Mendeley, citation from the COFAS, cross-reference, and link to open access article to import story. So this is the homepage of the ERINS. And in case of the ERINS, I am showing, because we have not yet incorporated the ERINS database in case of Vishwabharati, but hopefully near future, after increasing the Vidyan databases, we will open our ERINS databases soon. So I am showing the few another two universities of the ERINS pages. This is the homepage of the ERINS Indian Research Information Network System. This is about ERINS. This is the at present. I have already mentioned before, this is the updated databases, because this PPT is prepared the day before yesterday. This is the total faculty members among the all universities and institutions under the move of the InfliNet. This is the publication, total publication. This is the citation. So I am showing you the ERINS page of the Banaras University. After build up, this is the institutional wise BHU. You show the at a glance everything. At present, 994 faculty members have enrolled their Vidyan databases, because all the data fetching from the Vidyan databases. And this is the scholarly resources. And among the 994 faculty members, this is the professor, this is the assistant professor, this is the associate professor, this is the deputy librarian, and so on. And this is the age index of, as a, at a glance, is the Banaras Hindu University. So at a glance, we may produce university-wise, institute-wise, their representation in near future, in any publisher, in any ranking institution, whether it may be the NIR thing, they fetching the data from this such kind of reputed, government recognized databases. So this is the BHU Irins page, and this is the Aligarh Muslim University Irins page. So I am showing the top two Irins universities of this is the Aligarh Muslim University. At present, 468 faculty members and different categories of the professional enrolled in Vidyan databases. My humble request to the faculty members from this platform, those who are not yet enrolled in the Vidyan databases, please, please, please kindly enroll your Vidyan databases. If any problem, please send to us mail so that we can help you. So this is the and this is the another important Vidya Mitro. So Vidya Mitro is very important, another project maintained by the NME ICT. Vidya Mitro is an online learning portal for all the e-content project developed under the NME ICT. Very important. All the e-product is available under this Vidya Mitro. It is maintained by the Implement Center under the control of the MHRD. The portal provides facilities to search and browse all hosted content wherein a learner can easily access the desired material, including the audio visual learning material, textual material, multimedia archive material, etc., through a single interface. I am showing in the homepage of the Vidya Mitro. This is the homepage of the Vidya Mitro. This is the window, and you can search your need according to your requirement. Very user friendly. So my humble request to you all, please use. There are lots of so many ICT, and I add anything. The government of India, basically our Prime Minister Acharya Vishwabharati Narendra Modi ji, already mentioned so many times the digital India. This is the part of the digital India, and all the ICT initiatives are maintained by the Infinet. And this is the homepage of the Vidya Mitro, very user friendly, and this is the next page of the Vidya Mitro. So this is the another next page of the Vidya Mitro. This is the subject category, and this is the service facilities from the Vidya Mitro. And due to the shortage of time, it is not possible to explore everything. So I am trying to furnish in brief the popular services of the Implement. And Shyam Prabha, this is the another project, very important project. This is the Shyam Prabha is a group of 32 DTH channels devoted to the telecasting of big, high-quality educational program on 24/7 basis using the GSAT-15 satellite. And every day, there will be the new content for at least 4 hours, which will be repeated telecast by 5 times according to your choice, according to your time. And the channels are uplinked from the BISAC, Gandhinagar. The content are provided by the MPTEL, IITs, UGCs, IGNU, NCERT, and many more. And the DTG channels shall cover the following: the higher education, and the school education, and curriculum-based courses. I am not going through the details due to the shortage of time. So the coverages of the DTG channels are higher education, school education, and curriculum-based, basically the vocational training related. So this is the homepage of the Shyam Prabha. And it is also very user friendly. You may search according to your need. So I have just completed after my introduction. So due to the technical reason, I am very happy you are all with us at last due to the just such kind of technical introduction. So if you have any question, so you may ask directly through the question answer session. Otherwise, you may send to my email ID. This is my email ID. So actually, due to I completed my PPT through in a rush manner. So So that's why, if any opportunity in near future, we will arrange to. Arrange to present such kind of webinar in a single segment, in a single session. So Dr. Sanat Kumar Bhattacharya already sent me to 2 questions, which is already uploaded in the question answer part. So I am trying to answer this question. First question is, like to know the channels of this for French language and plagiarism detection software for English. So I have a question. So first question, a few of the participants already told me to send the PPT. So I am add another thing regarding the PPT.
All the PPT will be sent to the all participant along with their certificate.
Sure.
At the end of the webinar seminar, we will send all PPT of the all resource person to all the participant with their certificate.
So I am answering one question which is already told me, Sanoda, regarding the French journal and French language for Urkund. So this is for your information that I have completed also the fortunate or unfortunate certificate in the French. So the script is same remain as like English alphabet, but the language is separate. So in case of French language, it is not related to the Unicode support like the regional languages. So you need not you may follow in any English language. In case of English, there is no problem in related to the Unicode support. So in case of French, any article or French thesis, or need not require any such kind of Unicode support. And in case of French journal, so actually in case of journal, before in case of UGC enlisted list, now the UGC enlisted list been converted to the UGC KR list. So all the journal list of journals is available in the UGC KR list. But in case of KR list, it is not possible to show without having the logging. So first you have to logging to the UGC KR list. Having your email ID is the mandatory for your user ID, and create your password. Then automatically you enter the UGC KR list, and showcase will show what kind of journal is available subject wise. So if any question, I am also finishing my email ID also. If any question, you may send to the mail also. Urkund, okay. So I am answering the question in case of Vishwabharati. So actually before we are registering the Urkund to the support system, there is a support system in Urkund, but the scenario have been now changed. Our university librarian, Dr. Nimaichand Saha, is the nodal officer of the Urkund in case of Vishwabharati. In case of Vishwabharati, those are belong from the faculty member, those are only entitled the analysis account. Because we have all the in our hands. 2 months ago, we are circulating the link of the Urkund. And at the end, if you have a Urkund account, please send a mail to us or remind us. Kindly provide me the user ID and password along with the analysis account. Only the faculty member are entitled for the analysis account. So my humble request to you, the faculty members, please collect your user ID and password along with the analysis account and check the article or thesis of the scholar under your supervision. Because in case of library professional, we are not the subject expert. In case of self-plagiarism, it is not possible to explore everything, whether the publication before submission of the thesis is the same theme or not. So My humble request to you all, the faculty members of the Vishwa Bharati community, please collect your user ID and password and analysis account and clear the analysis by own. And I have already mentioned before that throughout the year we are the patient session of the account. You need any tutorial, please come with us or we are ready to start with you. If any question, otherwise. Thank you for bearing with us. So in spite of our technical hazards in introduction part.
Thank you, Dr. Kaushik Ghosh, for your nice informative presentation. Thank you again.
Thank you, Sanada and Tapata.
Sound আছে
Hello, Sanada, can you hear me?
Sanada, you have a question?
Yeah, Sanada, sir, can you hear me?
Yes, yes, tell me.
Sir, actually, I am doing this research activity, and it is going to be this year it is going to be finished. Actually, because of COVID reason, I think it may extend for some other months also. From doing PhD from ICFA University.
Okay.
And under these circumstances, before submission of thesis to the university, do you have any advice to me to go along with the latest? After this COVID situation, how to submit and any other additional documents or any other additional information is needed or something like that, sir.
So regarding the submission of the thesis, so sir, there is one notification on behalf of the MHRD. So already okay. MHRD mentioned this particular notice that after submission it will take another 6 or 7 months to collect the external report. So in case of the thesis, those already the external report will collected by the university, and please arrange the final defense of the viva through the online through Skype or webinar in such a way. So this is the one regulation, and maybe the extension of date, hopefully there is will be no problem for the extension of date due to the situation. So there are at least two notification on in case of the research. One is the extension of date, another is the online final viva. This is the only in case of the final viva.
Okay. Good, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
This is for the information.
Okay.
Hello. Hello.
Hello.
Yes.
হ্যালো স্যার, শুনতে পাচ্ছেন?
হ্যাঁ পাচ্ছি
স্যার। আমি একজন পিএইচডি স্কলার, আমার জানার ইচ্ছে হচ্ছে যেমন কলকাতা ইউনিভার্সিটি তাদের ওয়েবসাইটে গিয়ে আমরা পিএইচডি রিলেটেড কোনো থিসিস হোক বা কোনো পেপার দেখতে পারি, আমরা কি বিশ্বভারতীর আন্ডারে সেই রকম কোনো কিছু ব্যবস্থা রয়েছে যাতে আমরা সাইট থেকে পুরনো থিসিস পেপার বা কোনো কিছু জার্নাল ওটা দেখতে পারবো?
এটা
যদি কন্ট্রোল।
হ্যাঁ আমি বলি, প্রথমত আমাদের ইউজারফ্রেন্ডলি যে ওয়েবসাইটটা আছে সেখানে আমাদের থিসিস, আমরা যেমন বই সার্চিং করি থ্রু ওপ্যাক, তুমি বাংলাতেই করছো তো, আমি বাংলাতেই আনসারটা দিচ্ছি। তো আমাদের যেহেতু আমরা যখন বই সার্চিং করি থ্রু ওপ্যাক, কিন্তু সেখানে আমাদের প্যারামিটারটা ফিক্স করে নিতে হবে যে আমি কী সার্চিং করছি, আমি বই সার্চিং করছি না জার্নাল সার্চিং করছি। ইনকাম ক্ষেত্রেও থিসিসের ক্ষেত্রে থ্রু অপ্যাক আমার কি কি থিসিস অলরেডি অ্যাওয়ার্ডেড ফ্রম দ্য বিশ্বভারতী ইউনিভার্সিটি অল দ্য বিবলিওগ্রাফিক ডিটেলস ইজ অ্যাভেলেবল থ্রু অপ্যাক তুমি অপ্যাকের মাধ্যমে আমার আমার যা কিছু থিসিস অ্যাওয়ার্ডেড ফ্রম দ্য বিশ্বভারতী ইউনিভার্সিটি অ্যাভেলেবল সফট কপি অফ দ্য থিসিস আমি আমার ডেলিবারেশনের সময় বলেছিলাম আপনার 2009 রেগুলেশন দ্য সফট কপি অফ দ্য থিসিস অ্যাভেলেবল বোথ ইন আওয়ার সার্ভার অ্যাজ ওয়েল অ্যাজ দ্য শোধগঙ্গা সো তোমাকে ওপ্যাক সার্চিং এর মাধ্যমে সার্চিং করে নিতে হবে সার্চিং করে তুমি তোমার যে নির্দিষ্ট থিসিস থিসিস হোক বা ইয়ে হোক সেটা তুমি পেয়ে যাবে আর জার্নালের ক্ষেত্রে বলি প্রত্যেক বছর আমরা জার্নাল যেরকম আমরা পারচেস করি একটা প্রসিডিওর আছে আমাদের এবং প্রিন্ট জার্নাল পারচে প্রিন্ট জার্নাল আমরা পারচেস করি আর মোর দেন 7000 ই জার্নাল ফ্রম অ্যাভেলেবল ফ্রম দ্য ইএসএস প্ল্যাটফর্ম সো ইন কেস অফ প্রিন্ট জার্নাল লাইক 145 প্রিন্ট জার্নাল উইচ ইজ অ্যাভেলেবল ইন আওয়ার লাইব্রেরি ওয়েবসাইট অলসো দ্য কারেন্ট লিস্ট অফ জার্নালস দ্যার ইজ এ প্রভিশন আমার রিকোয়েস্ট তোমরা আমাদের লাইব্রেরি ওয়েবসাইটটাকে একটু ফলো করো খুব ইউজার ফ্রেন্ডলি সব কিছু আমাদের যা কিছু আছে যা কিছু বিবলিওগ্রাফিক ডিটেলস যা কিছু ডাউনলোডেবল সব কিছু আমাদের লাইব্রেরি ওয়েবসাইটের মধ্যে দেওয়া আছে
থ্যাংক ইউ স্যার
আচ্ছা সেশন ওভার সেটা তুমি একটু ইয়ে করে দাও ঠিকঠাক করেছে হোপফুলি সেশন ইজ ওভার অ্যান্ড ইফ এনি কোয়েশ্চেন প্লিজ সেন্ড ইউর কোয়ারি অ্যান্ড কোয়েশ্চেন টু মেল থ্যাংক ইউ ভেরি মাচ ফর লিসনিং অ্যান্ড বিয়ারিং উইথ আস
থ্যাংক ইউ স্যার
থ্যাংক ইউ ফর ইউর নাইস প্রেজেন্টেশন থ্যাংক ইউ
আমার তো প্রচন্ড মাথা খারাপ আমার তো মাথা খারাপ ওই বাবা আমি তো ভাবলাম বন্ধ করে দাও খুব মানে নার্ভাস বলছি ওই কোয়েশ্চেনটা আমাকে মেলে করে দিও ও এটা এটা কি অফার দেবে মিটিং